A whole bunch of our teams are on a bye week this week, but we still have some games to talk about, and we're about the midway point of the season, so Matt and I are going to break down who we think might be going to the playoffs in our various regions. All this and more coming up on Gridiron Central. Welcome to the Gridiron Central Preview Show. I'm your host, Jim Allred. Next to me, Matt Davis, the voice of high school football from 95.7 The Ridge. There's the fist bump. There's the explosion. We'll get right into it. Like I said, we don't have that many games to pick. We may go kind of quick through this. We start Ringgold at Sonoraville. The Tigers had a huge win last week against Adairsville. Looked very strong in the region. Sonoraville is 2-0 in the region, having won two consecutive games after starting the season 0-3. Matt, can the Phoenix make it 3 in a row?
I'm going to say probably not, because they're going up against Ringgold. Ringgold beat Dalton in overtime. They've beaten Heritage, also Gordon Central, Adairsville. They got a couple teams in there that are good teams that they were able to beat. And so when I look at Ringgold, you know, and their schedule, I can say that they beat the teams that they should beat soundly. Yeah. The teams that they should have been competitive against. They picked up wins, and the only loss they have is to Central Carroll, and they are a one-loss team. They're a good football team. So this is an extremely competitive Ringgold team. So Norville this year, there was a time where I was wondering if they would win a game. Yes. And it just so happens their schedule worked out where they got Coahuila Creek and North Murray, two teams that are kind of struggling this year. And so those aren't very impressive wins, except for the fact that when you're looking at a team that you think might not win a game this year, and they're able to put together a couple of wins, that's a very positive thing for them. May give them some confidence going forward. Not enough confidence to beat a solid, you know, full team like Ringgold is.
Definitely. The way I see it this way is the Tigers are for real. They're probably the second best team in Region 5 AAA. Ringgold, if you want me to eat those words, beat Cartersville, then you're the number one team in Region 5 AAA. That's going to be awfully tough. Sonoraville, yeah, those two wins may not have come against great teams, but guess what? Sonoraville didn't beat those teams last year, so kudos to the Phoenix. I think they're a much improved team over last year. They could sneak up and get some more wins, you know, get a couple more region wins. Hey, you may be talking playoffs. That might be a stretch, but I don't think the Tigers will lose to the Phoenix. Moving on, Gordon Central at Coahuila Creek. I'm just going to go ahead and pick this one. I'm going to go with Coahuila Creek. I think it could be close, but I think the Creek will win this one. Matt?
I'm with you. It's funny how everybody's adopted calling it the Creek. I think that came from our Northwest Georgia football program.
I'm not so sure. I think it's the fact that Coahuila is just hard to say.
It is
for me. Maybe it's not for you, but it's a lot easier to say the Creek than Coahuila.
Yeah, no. You mentioned something last year about how it sounds like you're about to sneeze or something like that. But anyway, to make a long story short, in this game, you're looking at two teams who are both struggling on defense. They're both giving up about an average of 28 points a game, somewhere in there. It looks like, for the most part, that Coahuila Creek has got a little bit better things happening in terms of the offensive side of the ball, and so for that reason I'm going to pick them. But this is a really important game for both teams because they're both 0-2 in the region. To get over the hump and pick up a region victory is going to be huge for whichever team's able to survive this matchup. I think it's Coahuila Creek.
Gotcha.
How did I say that, by the way?
Yeah, you said it fine.
I said it as fast as I could.
Well, I'm the one that always messes it up, trust me. North Murray at Adairsville. The Tigers reeling a little bit after the close loss to Ringgold last week. Guess what? It's not going to be 2 weeks in a row to lose for Adairsville. Adairsville takes their frustrations out on North Murray. They get the win. Matt?
This was one of the wildest games that I had the opportunity to cover last year up at North Murray. Adairsville won the game 70-55, and really, it looked like they had it won in the first quarter, and then some interesting situations transpired that let North Murray back in the game. that's not going to happen this year. I don't think North Murray is as good a team as they were last year. I think they're really struggling on the defensive side of the ball. They can put up some offense from time to time, but Adairsville is a much more complete team. As you've mentioned several times on the show, good special teams, good quarterback play, good running backs, and a pretty decent defense. They're a good football team. I think Adairsville wins this head and shoulders above North Murray.
Moving on, the only Floyd County team this week to actually have a game. It's out of the county, however. Rome traveling to Paulding County. Rome now 2-2 on the season in Region 5-5A. They play a total region schedule. I think we say that about a million times during the season. Paulding County is 0-7 all time against Rome. You go first, man. I'll go second.
Well, I was looking at Paulding's schedule, and it looks like they started a couple of weeks before Rome did. And so they have actually played six games to Rome's four, which is kind of interesting going into this game because they've got a couple of more games under their belt. Yes. They're playing this game at home. Will that factor in? Potentially so, but I think last week playing on the road for Rome and picking up that win was a big confidence boost for them in a game where, as we describe in every game they play in, must-win games. This is another one of those. I like Rome in this game. I think they've got a little bit more prolific of an offense. Yes. Their defense is not quite where they would like it to be at this point, and I think a lot of that has to do from what happened with Alatoona a couple of weeks ago, but they're giving up too many points on average. I think it's around 31.
Yeah.
But I think Rome will get past Paulding County.
I think the key thing with Rome, and I was actually out of Rome's practice this morning and talking to Coach Perkins, and something I saw when they played South Paulding and again when they played Alatoona, Rome had costly mistakes, whether it was turnovers or penalties at the wrong time, and a couple of times put the offense, the other offense in third and long, and the other offense was able to convert. If Rome can get off the field in third and long situations, cut down on the turnovers and the mistakes, I think they'll be fine, and I've said I'm not so sure they're going to make the playoffs. I'm not so sure I was right. In fact, I think I'm going to be wrong because I think Rome, over the second half of this season, is going to get better. I think the defense is going to get better. They're going to cut down on those mistakes. You got to win, you know, and I think Rome's going to do that. I think Rome's going to beat Paulding County and get ready for what's going to be back-to-back huge games the next 2 weeks against East and North Paulding. Moving on, Rockmart at Jackson. Yellow Jackets lost last week. This is Maynard Jackson, by the way. Everybody says Jackson, Atlanta. I don't know why. I guess there are two or three Jacksons running around. But must-win game for the Yellow Jackets. If the Yellow Jackets want to get the playoffs, you cannot lose this game. Close loss last week. I'm going to say, even though it's at Maynard Jackson, I'm going to go with the Yellow Jackets. Rockmart gets the win, Matt.
You know, very easily Rockmart could be 0-4 right now because we were at the game when they played Coosa. And, you know, I felt like in a lot of ways Coosa was actually a better team in that game. But at the end of the day, they were able to overcome a lot of mistakes and won that game. It's been a tough season so far for Rockmart. And I'm going to pick Jackson. They're 2-2, 0-1 in the region. This is also a very important game for them. But the one thing that I think that Jackson has got on Rockmart right now is their defense appears to be a little bit more stout. They're only giving up about 18 points a game to Rockmart's 32. And meanwhile, their offense is producing a little bit more as well.
Yeah.
But with that said, whenever I feel strongly that I'm picking right against Rockmart, they have some sort of an offensive explosion or score a bunch of points from the defense or something like that, and they prove me wrong. So I'm picking Jackson, but Rockmart will probably find a way to win the game.
The big warning sign I have about Jackson on this, number one, I think Rockmart's not a bad team, and I think they're getting better. I think Dan Duff's doing a good job getting them better week after week. Jackson's two wins are against teams that are combined 0-8 so far. So we really don't know how good we really don't know how good either of these teams are. I'm going with Rockmart. One last game to talk about before we start talking about the various regions. Ridgeland at Dalton. The Panthers 1-3 on the season so far this season. Playing at Dalton in what is really a must-win game for the Panthers, Matt.
Yeah, it really is. You know, the Panthers have had a big struggle this year. They're 1-3. You're looking at a team that last year played at the Dome for a state championship, but attrition has got them. They lost a lot of players, and that's shown. Hopefully they're a team that's going to be improving as the season goes on. I don't think it's going to be a banner year in terms of a playoff run or anything like you saw last year. So the best thing they can do is to get out there and improve. But you're looking at a Dalton team. They beat Cass, Gilmer. They lost a close game to Ringgold. They played against Calhoun fairly close. They've played some really good teams and have been competitive in every single game. I think Dalton is a better team than Ridgeland is at this point, so I'm going to pick Dalton in the game, and then hopefully for Ridgeland's sake, this is another step forward in trying to get some young players some experience and move forward and get better.
Definitely. So I'm going to pick Dalton in this one as well. I think the Catamounts have a little bit of revenge on their mind. Ridgeland's kind of owned Dalton the past two or three years. I think Dalton wants to get even with that. I think Ridgeland's young. They're going to get better. could even make the playoffs this year. We're not so sure about that. We've got to see how the rest of the region plays off, but we'll have to wait and see. After I pick Dalton in this one, after the commercial break, we'll talk about some various region predictions that we have. Stick around.
Begin your future at Georgia Northwestern Technical College. We offer degrees, diplomas, and certificates in over 200 programs of study. Choose a career in business, health, industrial, or public service. With the flexibility of day, evening, and online classes at any of our 5 campus locations, getting your education at GNTC has never been more convenient. There are many financial aid options available, including student loans. Apply now. Georgia Northwestern Technical College. Your college, your town, your future.
Welcome back to the show. I jumped the gun before the commercial break. We had one more game to talk about. That's River Ridge at Cedartown. I'm not so sure how I could forget that one with Nick Chubb already at 1,300 yards on the year. He is on pace to equal what he did last year. Had a 360-yard performance last week. Cedartown 5-0. Big region game for them. Look, the Bulldogs have a better defense. They have Nick Chubb. Did I mention they have Nick Chubb? Look,
did
I think
you have to mention they have Nick Chubb?
Everybody should know that by now. Just sing along with me. Look, Cedartown, I think, is a very good team. They continue to get better. 5-0, they're going to go to 6-0. Cedartown wins, Matt.
Yeah, unbelievable start of the season. You know, the key thing for me here is seeing Cedartown's defense do what they've done. They're only giving up about 16 points a game. That's got to be better than the numbers they were putting up last year. Offensively, Nick Chubb is doing his thing. They've added a little bit, you know, of a sprinkle of dimension to the offense, which obviously opens things up for Chubb to do more of what he does. And people that are not necessarily Cedartown Bulldog fans want to see this team make it to the playoffs and, you know, play several games in the playoffs to get the opportunity to see what this young man can accomplish in the playoffs. And I would love to see that personally. But in this game, you're looking at a team, River Ridge, 1-4. They've not had a very good season so far. Their defense has given up gobs of points to teams. Cedartown's going to have their way with them. I'm going with Cedartown in this game.
Gotcha. We both agree the Bulldogs should win this game. Now, moving on to a few predictions. We're about midway through the season. Still, the region picture's a little bit cloudy, so we'll give some predictions. Hey, we've been known to be wrong plenty of times before. Let's start with 7AA, Matt. Obviously, at number one, Calhoun and Model don't have region losses yet. They're both 2-0. Who do you think's going to take it? Who's your 2, 3, and 4?
Okay, well, obviously, you mentioned Calhoun. You can just go ahead and write them down. They're going to be number one. But then beyond that, you know, in the last several years, we've always felt like, okay, we'll put Calhoun here, then Pepperell here, and then you can sort out the last couple of spots.
Yeah.
And this year, it's like, okay, Calhoun's here. You know, Pepperell lost to Dade County last week, which kind of surprised me and a lot of other people. So things are just absolutely chaotic and wide open at this point. But the teams that I think will fill in those slots, and I'm not even going to try to predict the order because it's, to me, unpredictable at this point. I would say that Coosa's got a good shot. Also, Pepperell, you can never count them out. Model, and then Dade. And then, of course, the teams that you have left would be Murray County, Chattooga. Although Chattooga may cause an upset, and Armurchie. So,
who could also cause an upset.
Exactly. So, there, you know, to me, when I look at all those teams, it's going to be a dogfight. I mean, it's going to be a couple weeks before we can even really just start to have that conversation and feel confident about what we're saying. But, yeah, Coosa, Pepperell, Model, or maybe Dade round that out for me. But there might be some surprises along the way.
Yeah, the double overtime win Dade had over Pepperell kind of throws everything into disarray. I think Pepperell's still going to be in there. Dade's going to be in there. Coosa plays Dade next week. That's going to be a huge game. If Coosa can hand Dade a loss, all of a sudden we've got like a huge tie there. And don't leave Model out. Model hasn't lost yet. Granted, we're kind of giving it to Calhoun, but you never know. Somewhere along the way, someone's going to have to beat the Yellow Jackets. Is it going to be Model? Is it going to be one of our other teams? We don't know. We'll have to wait and see. But I also believe it's too early to count Armurchie or Chattooga out. Both of those teams have good defenses. If their offenses can put some points on the board, I think they could possibly sneak up as well. So, you know, I honestly think it's wide enough open right now that the only team I really pull out of there is Murray County.
Yeah, and the thing is, you mentioned Chattooga and Armurchie specifically. Those teams are both very plucky teams.
They are.
And, you know, the only problem that I see with both of these teams, and, you know, the most recent example of that would be Armurchie against Model. Model turned the ball over in their first three possessions of the second half of that game last week, and Armurchie could not really take advantage of it except for one of those times. Model tried to hand them that game, and they couldn't do it. And so, you know, when you have that situation, you got to find a way to capitalize on it, and they haven't been able to do that. But nonetheless, they were a much better team than I expected them to be when I got to see them play. So they're going to upset somebody, I think, at some point.
Well, and I think the thing with Armour and Chattooga, they both have good defenses. They need to be able to put some points on the board. If they can break through and put some points up on the board and hold another team down, you're talking about, I'm not so sure it's going to be an upset. They're going to come back and beat somebody. Watch my words. Both those teams are going to get what other people think are an upset win before the season's over. Moving on to 5AAA. Look, I've got Carsville penciled in at number 2 with Ringgold's win over Adairsville. I have them. I mean, Carsville number 1. Good Lord, did I say pencil in at number 2? That was a terrible mistake on my part. Ringgold at number 2. Obviously, if Ringgold upsets Cartersville, that would flip-flop. I have Adairsville coming in at 3-4. I think is wide open. You have a bunch of people that could possibly do it. Obviously, Sonoraville's 2-0 in the region so far. You never know. Matt, what do you think?
I'm with you on this one. Everything you said. Cartersville I had at number 1. Ringgold at number 2. Adairsville number 3. Beyond that, I know LFO and North Murray, maybe they fit into that picture somewhere. Yeah. But those first 3 spots, I feel really solid that that's the way that's going to shake out.
Definitely. Right now in 7-4A, again, we haven't even started region play. We're just about to start. As we head into region play, the two teams that really jump out at me, Cedartown in the A division, Northwest Whitfield in the B division. Crazily enough, Pepperell played both of those teams. Talk about two losses that really aren't that bad considering both of those teams are undefeated. You know, right now, if you had to ask me and say who's going to meet in the region play-in game for the championship, I would say it's going to be Cedartown and Northwest, which I think would be a phenomenal game to watch, but a little too early to predict, in my opinion, that region, Matt.
Yeah, I'm kind of with you on this one. And, you know, being that this is a region that I never get the opportunity to cover, I know the least about this one as compared to some of the others. But, you know, for one side of the region, I had Northwest Whitfield, Dalton, Southeast. Mm-hmm. Maybe Ridgeland fits into that somewhere. Yeah. But then I'm with you. The team to watch on the other side is, without a doubt, Cedartown. Yeah. And as I mentioned earlier, having the opportunity this year, it was such a disappointment last year that they did not make it to the playoffs. I really think that they're going to do it this year, and maybe they'll have some success. I certainly hope so.
Gotcha. Region 5-5A. Of course, Rome High is our lone representative in this region. South Paulding looks awfully tough right now, and last week's overtime win over Allatoona really bolsters South Paulding up there. Remember, Rome barely lost to South Paulding. Rome did lose to Allatoona by a couple of touchdowns, so you know they're already behind those two. The key for Rome, East Paulding and North Paulding, in my humble opinion, probably the next two teams that Rome's really going to have to worry about. East Paulding has been a powerhouse in Rome. I think it's lost 5 straight to them. East Paulding's not the team they normally are. So in 2 weeks, we'll see Rome East Paulding, then Rome North Paulding the week after that. So I think Rome is going to sneak in. I don't know who they're going to beat, but I really do believe Rome is going to grab the number 4 or the number 3 spot in the 5-5A playoffs, but I'm not so sure who gets left out there. Obviously, somebody is. The win over New Manchester was big. Matt, what do you think?
Yeah, you never know what's going to happen. I mean, I guess it was the first or second week of the season we saw a pretty major upset in the beginning in this classification, so you can never count that out as a possibility. And Rome, in terms of how they've been improving as the season goes on, they picked up a decent win last week on the road. You know, all signs point to them improving, so I would not be surprised to see them upset one of these teams down the stretch. But again, it goes to what you said. Who's it going to be?
Yeah.
Hopefully somebody, but, you know, right there at the top, you got South Paulding, Allatoona. Those two teams are just awesome teams. East Paulding, can never count them out. North Paulding, there's a lot of good teams in this region, and so you just really never know how it's going to shake out. It's fun to watch.
Exactly, and I think one of the big things is, well, let's talk about 6A real quick. We won't get into the B side of things. Let's talk about the A side where Darlington is. Darlington's win over Tryon was huge. Gordon Lee lost last week as well. I personally think that Darlington is the team to beat in this side of the region.
There's no question about that, and it's kind of interesting because going into the season, the question, the big elephant in the room is, what's life like without Brad Butler?
Yeah.
It's different, but not necessarily in a bad way. Yeah. Logan Rice has been a good quarterback.
Yes.
He's not Brad Butler. He does things in a different way, but he's able to take control of games and has done it a lot this season. And so I know his team around him has really enjoyed his leadership and has grown more confident as a result. And we always talk about Coach Atha and his coaching staff. They're top notch. They're going to take the hand they've been dealt in terms of their personnel and get the very most out of it. And when you see a matchup like Darlington and Tryon, we were all saying game of the week, game of the week. It was anything but that. It was a blowout. And so that's what happens when you're getting the most out of your players, and that's what they're going to do. So I'm definitely solid on Darlington up top. don't count trying out yet.
Yeah, no.
They're going to play some good football for it. It was over with. I know last year they had a couple of games where you're scratching your head and say, why were they not more competitive in those games? And then they'll come up and have some big games. So Trine's up there, Gordon Lee, Christian Heritage. And these are fun teams to watch, so it's going to be exciting to see how they do the rest of the way.
Definitely. And fans, don't fret too terribly much for two losses or against two private schools. And, of course, once the playoffs start, guess what? You're separated in single A with the private schools. One thing to note here, and I think it's very important, Darlington sits atop the private school power rankings this week. Of course, you know, really the power rankings mean a lot more toward the end of the season than they do right now. But the other thing that I thought was interesting, there are five 6A private school teams ranked in the top nine of the power rankings. So once Darlington clears, if they win the A side, they've still got two. They're going to have a tough opponent for that region title. You want to win the region title to get that high seed, but you know Darlington is doing well. And I guess the one thing Matt and I will probably agree on is that the second half of this season is going to be very interesting. In all honesty, there are very few of our local teams that are out of the playoff picture. We have practically everybody in it. And any game on any given week almost has playoff implications. What do you think?
There's no question about it. And from a coverage standpoint, you know, calling the game of the week on the Ridge and doing these shows and things like that, it makes it so much more interesting when you get to the second half of the season and it's not a foregone conclusion already what's going to happen. And I got to tell you, man, I'm kind of sad right now. It's like, gosh, I can't believe it's already halfway through. Of course, we say that at this point every year. It's amazing how quickly the football season goes by.
It definitely is. It definitely is. And of course, don't forget to catch all the action Friday night. We'll have live scoring updates from the games that are playing. We'll have articles, videos, photos, you name it, at PrepCentralOnline.com. Join us for the Gridiron Central Scoreboard Show that evening as well. Where we'll break down all the coverage, what happened, analysis of what happened in the scores, and of course, next Wednesday, get ready, because we're going to have the second half of the season starts, and we're going to have a ton of big games to break down. For Kevin Myrick and Matt Davis, I'm Jim Allred saying we'll see you on the sidelines.